Hey guys, this is Kellen from electricwheelchairsusa.com. In this particular video, we want to show you more about the popular scooter made by Enhanced Mobility. It's called the Triaxe Cruze. Now it has a sister scooter, it's called the Triaxe Sport, very similar, but there's a couple key differences between the scooters that I'll go over and show you. Also, if you'd like a free catalog sent to your home of our top selling scooters and power wheelchairs and lift chairs, you can go to the top of our website at electricwheelchairsusa.com. Click on free catalog and then you fill out your information. It takes about 10 days to get to you once we have that information. I like doing these kind of videos because a lot of times people buy these scooters and they don't get to see them in person. So I'm a tall rider, so it helps kind of put things in perspective. And I'm gonna show you, I'm actually 6'4" and I weigh 235 pounds. The scooter can support 350 pounds of weight. If I sit on the scooter, you can see where my feet are. So it's kind of snug. I'll be honest, like I'm a tall rider. So me personally, it doesn't bother me. Some people, this might bother them if they're like my height. You can actually stick your feet out here if you wanted to. But I think it's comfortable. It comes standard with this 18 inch wide seat. It does not have armrests, something to keep in mind. If you want armrests, it doesn't come with that. The top speed on the scooter is 6 miles per hour. The Triaxe Sport is more of a recreational scooter, so that top speed on that one is 12 miles per hour. It has one battery that is airline approved, the other one is not. This one only comes with one battery, which is located down here on the floorboard. That is airline approved. It also comes in multiple color choices. So this one is the blue one. Another important thing is, this is really a difference between the two. The Triaxe Sport is front wheel drive, so the motor is actually in the front wheel, whereas the motor on the Triaxe Cruze is on the rear wheel hub motor. So even though this one only goes 6 miles per hour, this one can tackle steeper terrains much better than the Sport. So if you want to take it in like a hilly area and you don't care as much about that speed, this might be a better choice for you. It's also safer of the two. Not only is it not as fast, but this has electromagnetic brakes. So it has this this throttle pod right here. So it's an ambidextrous throttle. So I can press this on the right side and go in reverse on this side, or if I'm left-handed, I can accelerate and go in reverse on the other side. Has your battery life. It's kind of hard to see right now because it's sunny. It is fully charged. This is your speed control. So if you want to get up to that 6 mile per hour top speed, just turn it all the way to the right. And this is your key. It's your on off switch. Pretty simple key. You get a set of two. This is your horn. And also comes with this front basket, which is really nice too. It's a nice oversized front basket. It has a handle. So if you were going shopping like farmer's market or something, you can take it off and you know, it's nice to have that option. Battery range on the scooter is 18 miles. Now, with it being airline approved, you're gonna have to remove the battery out of here and bring it on with you as a carry-on. And then you would fold the scooter and give it to, as a gate check to the airline. And then once you get to your destination, they would have it at the, once you get off the plane in the runway still, and then you would just take your scooter and put it back in. You can drive it through the airport.
Quick announcement, we're giving away a free scooter. Here's how to enter. First, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already. Next, comment below with your thoughts on this video and you'll be entered automatically. Stay tuned and good luck. Now let's continue with the video.
So as far as how to remove the battery, you need to, this is where the power source is, so I need to unplug that. So on the back of the scooter, you can see this little lever right here. I have to pull the, I'm gonna fold the seat back down, but I'm gonna pull this lever and you can drop it down on the floorboard. So it lays right on the floorboard like that. I'm also gonna take this out, the key. I'm also gonna remove this front basket. You just press this little red lever, you can pull it right out. And then right here, you wanna fold down the tiller. So you just pull this little knob and up like that. And this folds forward and this lays flat. Once you have the anti-tip wheels out like they are right now, that might not come like this. So they actually are flipped in when you first get it. So you can see how it's this little bolt is here. You have to pull it out like that. If you didn't want the anti-tip wheels, you can put them up, but in order to wheel it behind you, you want to make sure you have the anti-tip wheel sticking out behind these. And then at this point, I can wheel it behind me, or I can set it up like this. I pull this pin, and this is how you would remove the battery. So it's best to remove the battery after you have it folded, so that way you can just bring it on with you. By the way, this is also where you charge the battery. So you have to charge it directly on the battery. This is where the power supply goes to when you are ready to turn it back on. I'm gonna pull this pin, and we're gonna fold this back up in here, and it locks into place. Yeah, but now you can wheel it behind you like a piece of luggage in the airport. Also, this is like a safety feature I want to show. So when you have it folded flat, there's actually two height positions. A lot of people don't know this. So if I press this lever on the back and I lift it up, that's the first position, but it actually goes up higher. So if you have to press that lever again, make sure you don't have your hand in here. Actually, you can have your hand in here. That's fine. There's a little divot in here, but you can pull it up to that height. So that's where I would have it because I'm a taller rider. So Triaxe Cruze, really nice scooter, has a really sleek design. In fact, when I was filming this, I had someone stop me and was asking me all about it. So it's definitely a head turner for sure. The front wheel also has a suspension. So it has this front suspension on here, helps with absorbing bumps, a little smoother ride. So if you're looking for a great mobility scooter that is airline approved, has a long battery range, can go 6 miles an hour. That's actually faster than most mobility scooters. They're usually about 4 miles per hour. And the biggest thing is that it supports 350 pounds of weight. So you don't find many scooters on the market that can support that much. Triaxe Cruze is really a great scooter. It's well made. It's made by a great brand, Enhanced Mobility. They have one of the best warranties in the industry. In fact, if you purchase the scooter through Electric Wheelchairs USA, we will include a one-year labor contract for added peace of mind. So if anything goes wrong in the first year of owning the scooter, we're gonna try to troubleshoot that issue with you over the phone, but if we cannot get that resolved with Enhanced Mobility, we'll send a technician to your home to fix that issue for the first year. That's how much confidence we have in this product. So if you have any questions about it, call us. We're open every day. Our phone number is 1-800-682-9444. Or just visit us at electricwheelchairsusa.com. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.